San Francisco 49ers versus Kansas City Chiefs, getting ready. Fans are getting ready. Broadcasters, retailers, sponsors, all getting ready to cash in. Do you think it's still important for a brand to run an ad during Super Bowl?
Absolutely. It's tentpole TV. There's only a few events now on television that bring in a live audience.
What does that mean?
Well, it means it says I got to watch it live. I got to be part of the experience. I can't tape it. I can't binge it. If I'm going to be seeing the Super Bowl, it's now. It's also a great co-gender audience. So it brings males and females together. It's a gathering. People are happy. And ads, people don't run away from. They actually like the ads as much as the game because people have gone all in terms of what they bring forth in terms of their the showbiz of the commercials.
Let's talk about some of the numbers. I'm sure you've heard this. It's like 5.6 million for a 30-second ad that works out to about $175,000 per second. Is that a lot?
It's absolutely, but that's just the real estate. That's not talking about producing the ad, signing a celebrity, all the activation that goes afterwards. Plus, they take that ad nowadays and they put it out on Facebook and Instagram and media channels like you offer, and they buy media to support it. So we're just talking about an entry point being 5.6. There'll be people that are spending $50 or $60 or $70 million on that event alone because they feel they can get a return on investment.
A new frontier this year are political ads. And it's not just because, I mean, I guess you can take out an ad and it can run in the state, but this is on a national level now. U.S. President Donald Trump, Michael Bloomberg, who's in the running, have taken out these ads in an election year. What does that mean? It's the first time we've seen anything like that.
I think they're not going to be well received. I mean, the Super Bowl is about humor ads. The Super Bowl is about celebrities. There's a lot of very emotionally touching ads. You remember the Clint Eastwood or this year the Google ad. To have your political and use that to paint your slogan and your rhetoric, I don't think it'll be well received, especially in the states where 48% are Republicans, 48% are Democratic, and 4% swing voters. You're going to make a couple of people happy, a couple other people unhappy. I think it's a waste of money and a waste of time for these politicians to think that is their stage.
Tony, you mentioned some of these celebrities in these ads, and I'm wondering whether or not, at this point, if you get a really big name, do you think that kind of trumps the brand? Like, what's more memorable at that point? Is it the celebrity or is it the product?
The greatest challenge for a storyteller, you have 30 seconds to begin, complete, and end, and bring your brand in a way. At the same time, now you have a celebrity everybody's leaning into. So to try to write a story where your ad, where your brand belongs, it's not forced into it, and the celebrity is natural, doesn't look like it's shilling, is one of the tightest tightropes to watch in the creative community. When you pull it off, it's brilliant because you go, wow, did that all work together? That they really played with my brand. They brought it to life. They belong together. But if not, very often you go, I love that ad. I can't remember what it was for. And that's where you fail.
Right. Some of the most memorable ones that have stood out for you.
Well, I think over in the past, I mean, I still think Puppy Love with the puppies and Budweiser was an absolutely brilliant ad. This year, the one to watch, in my opinion, is Google. We're dealing with an aging population. Memory is the biggest issue, and we're not just talking dementia and Alzheimer's, just that people start forgetting their memory. And Google has showed how their technology allows this man who's lost his wife to remember key points in their life. And he sees a picture, says, oh, Google, remind me that she used to hate that mustache. Oh, Google, remind me how we love to dance. And then Google will bring back the pictures later on when he's trying to create recall. Brilliant use of technology, a great storyline, an emotional payoff. To me, that's a five-star ad. The other one you'll love is Smart Parking, which is using Bostonians, celebrities, to talk about Hyundai. You can press a button and your car parks itself, but they don't call it Smart Parking. Boring, stick a fork in my eye. I don't care. Smart Parking. Now everybody's going to go like, what's up? And start going Smart Parking at the end of the ad. And that's where you get that meme vernacular circulating in social media that, again, is a great use of a creative talent saying, that's the seed I'll plant and water, and let's watch it grow.
So I've heard you mention some of these big companies like Google, Budweiser. Has this become a forum now for the big fish? I mean, small fish need not apply at this point.
What happened a couple of years ago is you had the dot-coms raising all this capital and they got involved, you know, and the GoDaddy's like, what was that? What's that doing in the thing? So if you've got the capital, but it is a big dollar commitment. what I think is really smart is that people know, man, we can't afford it, but let's pretend we're going to do it. Like Carl Jr. always has an ad that's too hot for TV. So they're banned. They're not going to let it run on television. Well, that creates an itch with every male teenager.
I got to see Paris Hilton eating that burger.
Absolutely. And that's free media. And that's just, again, a careful use of the saying that all these media channels are like liquid. You know, content flows like liquid. There's no dead ends with great content. And if you're a small person who says, well, I can't afford the big stage, I can still find a way to have my water and my content surround it. And that's what, to me, is brilliant channel advertising.
So if you are a smaller brand, do you think it's worth blowing the budget on this, or are there alternative events? I mean, you mentioned like the top 10 kind of live events. Should you blow it on this, or should you wait for something else?
I wouldn't. If I was a small brand, I'd really understand who my audience is, where they're heading in life, what role do I play to help them get there? And then I'd say, what are the other places that I can connect with them? I might be at retail. It might be on their Instagram account. It might be in post media. I mean, it's depending on who they are, what they're interested in, how they're thinking, feeling, behaving. That's where I want to fly fish it. When you're doing Super Bowl, it's a statement that says we are a big brand with big dollars. And by the way, it's not just the ad. You're buying it. You're going to make sure every bar is painting Budweiser Super Bowl. You're going to make sure that everywhere that Budweiser is sold, there's a big Super Bowl display. You're going to, inside a case of Budweiser, you can get a Super Bowl helmet or some memorabilia. So it's massive activation. I mean, it's all the chips are in. Small brand, much more fly fishing. Big brand, big drift net.
So in terms of actually, bringing some of those numbers to life for some of these brands, small and or big, do you measure it in sales, or is it in awareness, just how you're suggesting now in terms of, branding everywhere?
Everybody tries to measure different ways. How many impressions, how much media did I earn that I didn't pay for in terms of shares and likes, social media validation. But ultimately, especially nowadays where everybody's focused on the bottom line, they're going to look at, did it drive sales? Did I activate it? Did it move cases? Did people choose Budweiser over Coors? The other side, if it's much more of a purpose-driven brand, they'll also say, did it change the way people think about my brand? So I look at Google. They're kind of moving into Apple territory with this ad. This is a kind of really, they're not really worried about, are you going to buy Google Photo tomorrow or buy a Google tablet. What they're more interested in this is saying, we're a brand in this world of high tech and data and everybody you're not trusting anymore and feeling kind of stinky about. We're over here. We're the good guys. And I think that's what Google's going to be focused on. Have I created that favorable impression?